A new pacemaker is giving heart patients new hope at Mercy's Heart Hospital. It's the world's first non-surgical retrievable pacing technology, and it's considered to be the next generation pacemaker, much smaller than the conventional one. Pacemakers are lifesavers for patients with heart rhythm issues. They provide electrical stimulation to keep the heart pumping at an adequate rate. And this pacemaker is a world's first. It's wireless, called a leadless pacemaker.
Typical pacemaker has wires that are associated with it. So these wires go underneath the collarbone, typically. And they actually go through a vein that sits in the heart, and these wires have little screws in them, and the back of it will connect to the pacemaker. And the typical pacemaker is about the size of a vanilla wafer, which we put underneath the collarbone. The neat thing about this is that there's no associated wires with it. So the computer, the battery, everything's encapsulated into this one unit.
Dr. Amit Doshi is director of the electrophysiology lab at Mercy St. Louis. He explains how this one unit is significantly smaller than traditional pacemakers. This AAA battery puts the size in perspective.
So it's obviously thinner, narrower. And the nice thing about it, like I said, is it's inserted through a vein in the leg as opposed to up underneath the collarbone, and because of its size, it's essentially able to sit into the heart muscle. It's got a little screw at the end of it, which we use an active fixation mechanism from down in the groin. And then there's a tether mechanism, like a docking station at the top here, where it actually connects to the release system, and then we essentially give it a little tug once it's in place after it's screwed in and make sure it's not going to float away. There's a little electrode there. So after it's attached into the heart muscle, that electrode is essentially what's sending the impulses. So that's in contact with the heart muscle, and that's what essentially provides each beat or rhythm.
Much smaller than a vanilla wafer-sized pacemaker, as he called it, with wires.
For a lot of patients who may have a contraindication to having a pacemaker placed in a traditional fashion or don't want the bulk of the system up underneath the collarbone, or have a contraindication in terms of a chemotherapy port, or they're a dialysis patient and can't get it, this is a good option.
Which is why this is the next generation pacing technology. The battery life is longer than a conventional pacemaker, and it's retrievable.
Say 10 years from now, 12 years from now, 15 years from now, if the battery starts to deplete itself and we have to replace it, the device was specifically designed so we could go back in there with a retrieval mechanism, essentially snare that docking station and then unscrew it, unsheath it, and then pull it back and then deploy a new one. Whereas with a traditional pacemaker, once it's in place, the wires scar down into the vascular system and it becomes very difficult to remove them.
Mercy St. Louis is the only hospital in Missouri offering the leadless pacemaker. The clinical trial recently concluded, but Mercy is allowed to continue enrolling select patients as the FDA analyzes the data from the clinical study.
Right now, it's limited to patients who have a certain heart rhythm problem called atrial fibrillation. That's essentially where the top chamber of their heart is going too fast.
Dr. Doshi says this is clearly where the technology is headed.
So the next phase of this is essentially allowing communication between the top chamber and bottom chamber using two wireless capsules, and they're using Bluetooth technology to allow communication between the two capsules. And so that's still in the works. It'll be several years away. I think that's where technology will go.